Vasco Núñez de Balboa was born in Jerez de los Caballeros, in Badajoz, Spain, in 1475. The exact date of his birth is unknown. Vasco's father was Nuno Arias de Balboa, and his mother was Lady de Badajoz. Very little is known about his family. What is known is that of four sons, Vasco was the third son. Vasco would marry, but it would be an unconventional marriage, to say the least. What was relatively common for the day, were marriages by proxy, and this was exactly the marriage Vasco Núñez de Balboa would have. Unfortunately, he would never get to meet his bride, and the marriage would be not only unconsummated, but childless. As far as education was concerned, Vasco would have begun his studies within his home, learning basic manners. He would have been taught to read and write, as well as how to handle weapons, and the art of warfare. Vasco was apparently privileged to have been sent to serve Don Pedro de Porta Carrero, Lord of Moga, at the time, to become his page, and later to serve as his squire. Vasco Núñez de Balboa, at the urging of his master, and upon hearing the great news of Christopher Columbus's exciting voyages to the New World, decided he too would embark on his voyage with Juan de la Cosa to the Americas. They decided to join the expedition of Rodrigo de Bastidas, who had a license. The license meant that of all, and any, treasure acquired by Bastidas, 1/5 was to be given to the king and queen, while the remaining 4/5 was retained for himself. This was known as the Quinta Real. Having traveled to the New World, with his share of the earnings, Vasco decided he would try his hand at farming and animal husbandry. It was not to be, and Vasco was forced to rethink his future. Having no money, he made the decision to stow away on a vessel. He would eventually be found out and threatened with being left on the next deserted island. With luck, and thanks to his extremely likable countenance, Vasco was spared the punishment. Also, he had great knowledge of the region and proved rather valuable. After a victorious battle with the natives, the Spanish contingent settled in Santa Maria la Antigua del Darién, the first permanent mainland settlement on American soil. Vasco Núñez de Balboa would become most well known for founding the settlement of Santa Maria la Antigua del Darién, which is in present-day Panama. As a conquistador, Balboa would succeed Nicusa, after his disappearance at sea, to the governorship of Veracruz. Vasco would continue befriending some tribes, whilst defeating others. During his travels he was able to explore swamps, rivers, and mountains, always on the lookout for any gold riches to be had. During an expedition to the mountain peak of Darién, Panama, Vasco Núñez de Balboa was the first European to set sight on the Pacific Ocean. He would immediately lay a claim to, not only the ocean, but all the land in the name of Spain. Routes to the coast would be explored and established. Vasco Núñez de Balboa, in search of ever more riches, and eager to explore the Pacific Ocean, arranged to recruit men from Cuba. When Pedrarias discovered this, he was not only furious but had Vasco arrested. The local bishop interceded and arranged a marriage between Balboa and Pedrarias's daughter, and in so doing created a connection between the two men. The marriage was conducted by proxy, and Vasco would never actually meet his bride. Life for Balboa would not go as planned, and upon his return for sturdier ships, at the urging of Pedrarias to meet with him, Balboa traveled to meet with him. Along the way he would encounter Francisco Pizarro, and in the name of the governor, would have Balboa arrested. Balboa insisted he be transported to Spain to stand trial, having denied all charges, but Pedrarias refused. The trial took place, and Vasco Núñez de Balboa was found guilty. Vasco Núñez de Balboa was executed, together with four others, by beheading with an axe, and their heads put out for public display. His final resting place is not known.